Thank you for joining this CS Board video about Soft Mixture of Experts, a new research paper from Google DeepMind titled From Sparse to Soft Mixtures of Experts. In recent years, we see that transformer-based models are getting larger and larger in order to improve their performance. An undesirable consequence is that the computational cost is also getting larger, and here comes Mixture of Experts, which helps to increase the model capacity without paying the full computational cost, and based on reports, it is used by OpenAI in GPT-4. However, this method also has drawbacks, which the new method presented in the paper helps to resolve. In this video, we will explain the paper and understand how the method works and why it can potentially help with improving over GPT-4. First, it is important to understand what is Mixture of Experts. The common methods up until now are sparse Mixture of Experts. The idea with Mixture of Experts is that instead of having one large model that handles all of the input space, we divide the problem such that different parts are handled by different experts. So what does it mean? In high level, we have a router component and experts component, where the experts component is comprised of multiple distinct experts, each with its own weights, and given input tokens, such as the 8 tokens here, each token passes via the router, and the router decides which expert should handle this token, and routes the token to be processed by that expert. More commonly, the router chooses more than one expert for each token. So in this example, we choose 2 experts out of 4, and then the chosen experts yield outputs, which we combine together. These experts can be smaller than if we would use one large model to process all tokens, and they can run in parallel, so this is why the computational cost is reduced. The flow is repeated for each input token, so the second token also passes via the router, and the router can choose different experts for it. For example, here it chooses the top expert, same as before, and the third expert instead of the last, and it goes on for each input token. Of course, the tokens are handled together, and we do not do this one after the other as shown in this example. There are various techniques to implement the routing logic, which we won't dive into here, but it is important to say that since we choose specific tokens to pass, it requires to solve a discrete optimization problem, which is hard, and this is causing issues with training and makes it hard to scale up the number of experts. Before moving on, if you like this content, then please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. Let's now move on to understand what is Soft Mixture of Experts. The goal here is to maintain the benefits of Sparse Mixture of Experts while mitigating the challenges. So how does it work? Well, we still have the layer of experts as before, and we use the same number of experts for simplicity. But now, given the input tokens, instead of passing each one of them via a router component, we have weights for each expert, and we pass all of the input tokens via each expert weights to yield the input for the expert. In the example here, the input for the expert is of size 4, so we have 4 slots, and each slot in the input is a linear combination of all input tokens. So in the weights layer, we actually have weights per slot per expert. And this process is repeated for each expert. So, for the second one, we also get the linear combinations, and same for the third expert, and for the fourth expert. Each expert then yields an output for each of its slots, and then the expert results are combined together, where we know how much each expert should contribute to each slot in the final result, based on the relative weight this token got from the first step. The final output can be chained to another similar layer. To make this new method more clear, let's also review a diagram from the paper. In this diagram, we see what happens inside a soft mixture of experts layer. On the left, we see we have n input tokens. They are first passed via per slot weights to create the n by s matrix of logits, where n is the number of input tokens and s is the number of slots across all experts. Then we soft max per slot, meaning that for each slot here we have the weight of how much is this slot going to be impacted by any token. We then create the linear combination for each slot. In the example here, each expert has 2 slots. In the more simplified overview before, we encapsulated the steps up until here with the weights layer, and here we saw it in a bit more details. Next, the experts yield the results for each slot as we saw before, and then we combine the expert results using another softmax over the original logic. This time by a token, so for each token we know how important it was for each slot, and so we consider the expert slot result for each token appropriately. The code for this soft MoE layer is available, and you can find the link in the video description. Now that we have a better understanding, to re-emphasize the difference between sparse mixture of experts and soft mixture of experts, consider this picture from the paper for sparse mixture of experts, where we see that each expert has few possible slots, and we assign tokens from the input to the slots, so each expert is looking at different parts of the image here. While with soft mixture of experts, we see that similarly the expert has slots to fill, but each one is filled with the weighted average of the input tokens. Looking at the example of a patch being assigned to a slot, we see on the sparse MoE that we see the image patch as is, while on the soft MoE we see that it is a mix of the different image patches. Unlike sparse MoE, which requires assignment between tokens to experts, all of the operations in soft MoE are continuous and fully differentiable, which helps to solve some of the training issues. This is possibly also what helps this method to scale up the number of experts. If this method will be applied successfully to large language models, it can be the driver to improvement over GPT-4, which is using mixture of experts according to reports. Additionally, while in sparse MoE, a token cannot be assigned to any expert, or one expert could be assigned with much more tokens than other experts. Here, all tokens are taken into account in each expert, so there is no token dropping or expert unbalance. To show the great potential of this method, let's see some of the results from the paper. They run extensive experiments in visual recognition, and starting with JFT4B, which is an internal Google Images dataset, they show in this chart the performance of soft MoE in blue and other MoE methods in orange and green, and visual transformer in red. The x-axis on the left chart is TPU days, and on the right chart is exaflops, and it is clear that given same allocation of resources, soft MoE outperforms visual transformer and other MoE methods. And a similar trend is observed when they measure the results on ImageNet, as we can see on these two charts on the right. In order to dive deeper into the comparison of soft MoE versus visual transformers, the paper includes the following table. Looking at the largest model of both methods, a noticeable achievement here is that the inference time is much faster with soft MoE, while results are slightly better. However, the memory footprint of running soft MoE seems significantly larger. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again in the next video.